learning about biodiversity, and you might be wondering, why do we have geography up on the board? But we'll answer that in a little while. Right now, I want everyone to find a partner and grab a writing utensil. I don't care if it's a pencil, marker, pen. Chart, we have continents on one side and a characteristic on another. Obviously, we have the seven continents here, so let's start with North America. If we were to list some characteristics of North America, what come to mind?
Big.
Big? Okay, what else?
Diverse.
Just shout them out.
What?
Diverse.
Okay. How?
Geographically, let's say.
Okay.
It's got mountains, it's got plains.
Mountains. And plains?
Yeah.
Rivers, forests.
Forests, good. How about South America?
Spanish.
Warm.
Jungles.
Rainforests, rather.
Rainforests.
Okay. Mountains.
Anything else?
Hot.
Hot, good. I'm glad you mentioned the weather. What about North America? Is the weather hot?
Very.
I'm not sure about Mexico.
In areas.
In areas? Okay. All right, let's move on to Antarctica. It's kind of like the next extreme.
Cold.
Icy.
Paris.
What was that one?
Penguins.
Okay. Europe.
Diverse.
Okay. How so?
Culturally and ethnically.
Okay.
And probably geographically too, or terrain-wise.
Terrain, yes. It's very diverse terrain-wise.
And actually weather-wise also.
Correct. You'll always know it's raining like it is all now in England half the time. Okay. Asia.
Big.
Yes, it is big. It is actually the largest continent, Africa being the second largest. So anything else about Asia? Notice it has a lot more coastline than anything else. Maybe Antarctica has a little more, but it does have a lot more than Europe, yet they share the same region latitudinally. So maybe we could say that's one of the characteristics of Asia. How about Africa?
Hot.
Hot.
Very.
We've got a
and
big
just,
old desert. At least one big old desert.
And a rainforest.
Right, it has both. That's key. Can anyone tell me where on Africa the rainforest is versus the desert?
Desert's up top.
If the equator's here.
Desert's above the equator and around the equator. The Congo is in like the little...
The little scoop hook. Right here?
Scoop, yeah.
Okay.
Down to the right.
How about Australia, the last one?
Small.
Small, correct. That is the smallest one. It's hot. What about its terrain? Does it have mountains?
It's
plains.
Tropical and desert-like, isn't it,
maybe, or? I wouldn't necessarily say tropical, but it is wet in certain parts. They have more of like a wet season versus dry season, so it has seasons as well. Okay. So with your partner, I have here the first step of our project that we're going to be working on. We're going to be folding and facting all at the same time. So I've already done the first step for you. So let's explore some animals that we find on North America. Sorry, the hyperlinks don't work, so I can't touch the smartboard. I've got to go over here to the computer. Okay. So here, you'll see on every slide it is uniform. We're going to be looking at birds, fish, and bears of all seven continents. As you can see, this is a turkey. With Thanksgiving coming up, I felt it was appropriate. We have a bluegill down here, and then a grizzly bear over here. Now, would you say these are normal animals in North America, typically you'd find? I think so. Now, on your sheet of paper, I don't care where, I want you to write another observation you have about the animals in North America. Are they colorful? Do they all look the same? How diverse are they? And these are your thoughts. If you get stuck, you can consult your partner. That's why you have one. See, a couple of you came in late. Okay, so you have that written down. Why don't I have someone share that with the class? What's your observation?
We eat them all.
We eat them all. Correct, we do eat all of them.
I put down they're not as colorful as maybe on some other comments.
Okay.
I said they're...
Go ahead, Susie.
I said they're all earthy colors.
Correct. Dr.
They're
Hicks.
All brown and boring. There's no panache or flash here.
No, there's not.
Even the rainbow trout is muted. So
blue.
Yeah, but even rainbow trout that aren't there are muted compared to like this crazy stuff you see when after vomiting.
All right, so we're going to go to the first step of our folding project. You can see that we're already in a triangle, so I want you to unfold the square and fold it the other way so that you have an X on the paper. And it's going to look like this. We now have an X on our paper. I want you to leave it open, and then we're going to talk about the next continent. Where do you guys want to go next? Someone shout somewhere else.
Europe.
No. Just worked on my Mac, I promise. All right, where are we going?
Europe.
Europe? Okay. Now notice, that's on the same latitudinal, almost, as North America. So keep that in mind when you look at the animals. So does the bear look similar? That's the brown bear of Europe, and then we have a bird that looks similar to probably our house sparrow, that the males have bright red, and the females would be all brown. And then this, does anyone recognize this fish? I can't be the only girl
it's
that fishes in here.
Come
on.
Or something, is it?
No. It's a freshwater fish. It's also known as a panfish. You can catch it in Lake Arthur, a stream. It's a perch. We can catch them around here, and also they're found in Europe. I don't know if they were brought over or not. That'd be good for someone to look up. If they have a smartphone right now, you can use that technology. I permit it. Okay. So write down an observation, again, on your paper. I don't care where. Write down an observation about these animals or any other animals that you know about in Europe. And we're going to share some. Name some similarities to North America or some differences that you see. And once someone's done, why don't we have someone share that? Ellen?
I just put match the environment.
Okay. Go ahead.
They can all live in cold climates.
Okay. Anyone else? Okay, let's move on to our second step. Okay, so we're going to take our X, and we're going to make one line vertical. And we're going to fold the bottom corner up to the center where the lines intersect. It's almost going to look like a kite with one end taken off. Okay. So what continent do we want to visit next?
Africa.
Okay. Now what do you notice about these animals? Especially the fish. Very colorful. And we have birds that are very extravagant, maybe long legs to run on the plains of Africa. But notice the bear is very similar to Europe and North America. Fun fact about this bear, it's extinct. It no longer lives in Africa. Why do you think that?
Couldn't survive in the conditions.
Take your answer and write it down anywhere on your sheet. And then we'll share.
Doesn't matter if it's from Africa.
Doesn't matter. I'll explain why later. What were some of your thoughts as to why that Atlas bear is extinct? Ellen?
Maybe the predators that are around it?
Okay.
Maybe it's too warm.
Too warm? Okay. poachers. Good answer. Do you know that there's rhinos, actually? I believe it's black rhinos or white rhinos. They actually have an armed guard surrounding the last three of them because they don't want them to go extinct out in the wild. There are some in captivity, but in the wild they actually have an armed guard. Anyone else want to share anything about why they think this bear is extinct? Okay, our next step, step three, will be to fold this paper in half. We're going to leave the folded part in the middle, and then we're going to fold it in half, like so. And if you're confused, ask your partner first. And if both of you are confused, then raise your hand. I know origami can be challenging sometimes, but we're indulging in the Chinese culture today. See, we're learning geography and culture all in one day. Okay. Where would we like to go next?
Australia.
Australia? All right. Now, what can you tell me about these animals? We have the kookaburra, koala bear. Any similarities or differences to animals we've seen before? Ellen?
They're not animals that we would find in our continent.
No, they're not. We would not find them in North America, but do their colors look similar to the ones?
Yeah, the colors are pretty neutral.
Okay. Why do you think the colors are neutral?
Survival.
Survival. Okay, notice it's on the bottom latitude, which is close to the pole, whereas we're on the top lateral, which is close to the pole, whereas we kind of explored Africa, which was in the middle. So we're kind of seeing a pattern here. All right, again on your paper, I don't care what side, write down another observation that you might have, something I didn't mention, or question that you're thinking about. And then we'll share it with the class. Question could be, why are we doing this? Why does this apply to the real world? Or, I really like that animal. Maybe I'd like to go to Australia someday. Just your thoughts. Anyone like to share? Dr. Hicks?
Why are so many weird animals in Australia? Like platypus and that koala bear. Like, they're just bizarre. Like they're put together wrong.
Well, we're actually going to be talking about that tomorrow in our little lesson about evolution, and we're going to dive more into biodiversity. This is just an introduction for today. All right, so our next step, step four, we're going to do this to both sides of your paper. You're going to take this corner outside, and you're going to fold towards the black dot, which is about a half inch above the bottom of the paper. So you're going to follow the arrow and make your crease where the dotted line is.
All the way to the edge of the paper?
All the way to the edge of the paper. It should look like this. It should have some wings. If you get stuck, ask your partner. If both of you are stuck, raise your hand and I'll come around. Did everyone fold their paper correctly? Jim, don't throw that. Okay, where would we like to visit next?
South America.
Okay. Now this is a speckled bear, and I'm sure some of you have seen the macaw before. Notice its bright colors as well as the fish. They're both bright. And this bear, you could say, is a little more eccentric than the other ones we've seen, with its speckling in its face. So again, write down some observations anywhere on the paper, or a question you might have. Ellen?
I said unusual.
Unusual? Why do you say they're unusual? Is it because we live in North America and you don't see them, or?
Yeah, I mean, some of these are things you wouldn't see. Or I've only seen a pet store because they came from South America. So.
Okay. Anyone else? Okay. So let's move on to our next step. Step five, I believe. All right. This step tricked me up at home when I did this. I'm not going to lie. You're going to take both sides, I believe, the way I did it, and you're going to fold. be flat on the bottom. If you have any questions, ask your partner, and if you are both stuck, raise your hand. It'll become flat, parallel with the other side. It's going to be parallel with the other side here. You can use mine as an example. We're running low on time.
Having a little trouble.
So we're going to go to Asia next. We have the cute little panda bear, a brightly colored bird. Again, on your paper, write down some observations or knowledge you have of the animals in Asia. And if you know what this fish is, write it down. It might look similar to a goldfish, or you find them in ponds, or people have tattoos. If you know what that fish is, write it down. Okay. All right, we're going to move on to step number 6 of our origami project, once you've written that down. You're going to take that and expand it outward, You're going to take this little fold, and this one is a little more difficult. You're going to take it and you're going to take the fold and push it inward and reverse fold that crease you just made. You folded them like that, and oh no, you folded the wrong end.
Uh oh.
I don't know what you did. It's okay, Susie. Just leave yours like that. It'll be okay for the end. All right. Now they might look a little messed up, but that's a good thing. And your observations are written in different places. That's a good thing. So everyone knows what Antarctica looks like. I'm going to leave that one go, and we're going to move on to step 7 so that we can finish this project. I want everyone to take the top of their origami and fold it sideways. So now you have a head. What does this resemble? It's a little bird with wings and a head.
Penguin.
Penguin, right. And where do they live?
Antarctica.
Right. So now we have penguins. And everyone, look at your partner's penguin. Is it the same as yours? Are your observations written in the same place? Do you think they're diverse, even though they're the same species? Yes. Everyone's penguin. Susie's is deformed. That happens in evolution. It is humans, mice, penguins.
Who's one of those talking?
Okay. So in short, biodiversity is the degree of variation of life forms within a given species, ecosystem, biome, or as we examine, an entire planet. So as your homework assignment, I would like you to journal about what you think the smallest biodiverse environment is. I would like you to just use your own imagination, your own thoughts for this. Do not go to your peers' internet. And we'll share this tomorrow at the beginning of class, and then we'll continue on a more in-depth view of biodiversity.